is. Try to remember. I'm not. Dominic, stop. Dominic Murphy. That's who I am, yes. This is Dr. Murphy reporting. I'm a geologist, part of Professor Carver's planetary survey team, but I think they're all dead. I was looking at the stones when the sidewinder arrived. I watched them come down like birds with broken wings and lights flickering on and off, just like the base of this today. There were soldiers everywhere with rifles and armored suits. I think they loaded a cage onto one of the ships, which took off again, just about. Many of you were the soldiers. I saw the flashes inside the buildings. Gunfire. Something exploded. The main comms relay, I think. But then came more lights. Strange lights, like that rippled like snakes, and darkness again, opening up in the sky. They tried to get away on foot. Running out to where I was hiding, and I thought he'd see me. And they were all flying up like toy soldiers, thrown in the air, pulled up into the lights. Now it's just us. Me and the stone. I can hear. Much louder now, but not hurting like people's voices used to. Loud, but far away. So
it's Friday, the 20th of October, 3111. This is Professor Penelope Carver. I'm making this log for our own records, and keeping it separate from the official logs we're sending to our employer. Why? Well, I'm still concerned about working for Azimuth Biochemicals, to be honest. Obviously, we take on all sorts of contracts for a living, and this isn't our first top-secret commercial project. Rumors about this corporation. Anyway, my people can handle anything, I'm sure. Azimuth are certainly paying well for our skills, given that. And those debts of mine aren't going away by themselves. More scientific value than I expected. We established a site on this planet on the 13th after we detected some very odd signals, and the whole team is excited about what we found. That's another reason I'm logging this. If this turns out to be a big discovery, I want our names attached. The things growing here are like nothing on record. Definitely organic life, but with crystalline or metallic elements and chemistry that even O'Keefe can't make sense of. They're giving off signal bursts on all sorts of frequencies. So are they living organisms or machines of some kind? Murphy and Sheng both think they're alien in origin, as in constructed by non-humans. But Kamalo found that so hilarious, we had to turn off his comms. Our transport ship is long gone by now. But Taylor's using the beacon to transmit our findings back to the company in the Chukchan system. She said the built-in encryption software is top of the line. Which makes me think the stories about Azimuth and its rivals might be true. They obviously want to keep whatever we find, or to them.
bloody find something.
This is Professor Carver, 27th of October, 3111. Hopefully this log will record. Half of our equipment isn't working properly right now. Everything's changed since we found the crashed ship. For one thing, it's alien. Definitely non-human technology. I should sound more excited, I know. Every scientist's dream, isn't it? Something about this just feels wrong. I know the others feel the same. Even Kamala isn't smiling anymore. We're still mostly in the dark about the object we retrieved from inside the wreckage. Is it the pilot, or the cargo, or maybe some organic component of the ship itself? It seems totally inert, but we've had electromagnetic interference all over the base since we brought it back. That can't be a coincidence. Starting to cause problems. Shane lashed something together using the strongest bulkheads he could find, but apparently it's still breaking that down. Equipment failures meant O'Keefe couldn't fully analyze its chemical structure, making him so angry that he actually attacked Kamala for telling him to calm down. I've never had to break up my people like that. We've worked together for years. It's Murphy I'm most worried about, though. He can't tear himself away from those growths on the surface. The stones, he calls them. Like the Neolithic standing stones on Earth. We keep finding him out there in his suit, standing under the jet black sky, staring at them. He won't tell us why. We've been sending back reports, but Taylor just relayed a message that made my blood run cold. Azimuth has ordered us to cease all transmissions and await the arrival of their megaship, the Adamaster, which will transport us and our samples to a secure facility. And now I'm wondering why I got involved with a corporation that's rumored to have its own private army. Everyone at risk by taking this job. I'm going to try making this log again. While the data drives are still functioning, they could go again at any time. Nothing works properly anymore. Especially not us. It's the 30th of October. The object in our storage cage has become noisy. I have a suspicion it's even noisier on infrasonic frequencies, which would explain why everyone is on a knife's edge and unable to sleep. I would ask Mahmoud to do some studies, but he's in the infirmary after his run-in with Kamala. God, I've never seen my team like this. What's wrong with them? But that's not the important thing. I don't think the ship that crashed was alone. Yesterday, O'Keefe came bursting in through the airlock like a pack of wolves was after him. He said there were lights shining down on the growths and on Murphy, who was just standing there. He couldn't make out where they came from, only that the nebula above us seemed to be moving. He said the night was opening up like a giant mouth. I don't know where Taylor's got to, so I tried the comms beacon myself and found a message saying the Adamaster has arrived in the system. That should be a relief. But actually, it twists my gut. What are Azimuth going to do with the thing we found? And what are they going to do with us? Thank you. rest of my team. We were furious. Weirdly, so were some of the soldiers. Mercenaries, just like the rumors said. They demanded to know why half their squad had been left behind, but the bridge crew refused to explain anything. Then, the power fluctuation started. Shane O'Keefe and I knew what was coming. And the cage they've constructed in the cargo hold isn't going to be strong enough. Even the Adamaster's hyperdrive keeps failing. They're making emergency repairs to it now, while we're passing through some unexplored system with half the ship in darkness. And this sounds crazy, but even though the nebula is 300 light years behind us, it feels like it's reaching out, trying to drag us back, swallow us whole. When all the security systems crashed, I took my chance and broke into one of the sidewinders, and we're going to jump ship. I need to get my people out, the few who are left, and I'm the reason they're here, my stupid, selfish greed.